like the lifeboat are out doing their jollies today. One right out over there, I don't know if we can see it, there he is. Let's see if we can zoom in a bit. Wow. Let's see if we can take a photograph. I've turned the paper over, and what I'm doing now is I've got one of these sponge applicators and I've put some zest it on it, and I'm going to blend that into the oil pastel, basically turning it into paint. It's the first time I've ever thought about it. It came to me while I was off the camera. So if it works, it works. If it don't, well, at least I tried. I think what I do need to do is to give that a wipe and perhaps start from the bottom. I suppose I could use a cotton tip for this, but that would take so long. So I'm going to start from the bottom and see what happens. I need a bit more zest. Just a little bit, not much. Yeah, it's good. Yeah, I think I found something new that I might be able to utilise. It's good. Very good. Certainly never seen anybody else do this before, so it could be of interest to people. And once it's dried, I can probably always go back over. So we'll just see where we are. Little bit. Scrape it off. Top of the boat. If I lose the boat, then I just have to draw back in again over the top. Okay. Oh yeah, I've got a nice blend going on there. Love it. Well, I'm quite impressed with that. My advice would be to start with the light colours and work up into the dark colours. In this case, I kind of pulled it off because I was a bit lucky. I had a little bit of blue mixed in there, and that's kind of helped. Got a bit of a blue grey going on now. So yeah, new thing, sponge applicator. Who would have thought, eh? Right, that's all dried. Look at that, it's lovely and smooth, just like oil paint. I really need to get some interest into this sky. So I'm just testing a few blues. Not really sure what I'm going to do with it yet. Oh no, that one's too dark. This one's probably too dark as well. Yeah. Not sure what I'm going to do with it at the moment. What's this here? It's got quite a nice tinge to it. I'll put a little bit on. I can always change it. I've got loads of texture left. I'm just going to rub that in. See what happens. Oh, look how that's blending. Wow. Oh, so many possibilities. See, I'm not sure if I'm going to put any clouds in here yet. I really just don't know what I'm going to do. I'm going to work that out as I go along. I'm amazed at that colour. That's stupendous. I'm going to put a little bit more of that in here. I'm going to put a little bit through here. And I'm just going to play around. You need a little bit of interest in the sky, you see. going to blend it down. A little bit of colour there. That is amazing. It's almost like a soft pastel, but better. Look at that. There's already some interest in the sky. That is incredible. I love it. I absolutely love it. Right, so I'm just gonna, let's have a, what's this, silver grey? Yeah, we'll put a little bit of silver grey down here. Just to see what happens. Just to see if we can lighten it up a bit. Down the bottom. And we can. Put a little bit of whiteness in. Just to whiten it up a little bit. It's amazing. Let's have a, let's go with a cotton bud and see what happens. You get a blend. It doesn't blend quite as much as with your fingers. Colour shapers to get the actual detail. And that comes from here. All the way through here. Okay, so I'm going to just try to draw this straight line with the paper stump. Yeah, as I suspected, there's a lot more control as opposed to the colour shaper. Albeit, this would not be as good for filling in. I'll show you this. This bit just made me laugh. This bit is so easy. I'm even doing it left-handed, but so it's just a case of filling it all in. And I'm filling it in left-handed. You can already get the impression that it's C, can't you? Well, I hope you can. But, you know, I can come right down here, all up to the shapes, all left-handed. It's only because of the position I'm standing in. So, you know, just keep going. I've decided blend it down. My main reason for that is that look how quickly the oil pastel's going down by doing that. If I was to blend it by finger, it would have gone down a long way. So I want the colour to spread about a lot more than what it has now. So if I blend it down, the colour's going to spread a lot more. Soft rubber shape where I'm doing this crisscross pattern. Just going to do this bit at the moment. I'm going to have another look at it because I want it to be a lot more detailed than what it is. And there's some more darker bits in it as well. Got little bits of green going on in here. Kind of guessing as I'm going along and how I'm going to build this up, which to a certain extent I think a lot of people do anyway. I'm sure it'll work out. Every now and then I'm doing a bigger chunk. Thank you.